हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज साक्षी पाटिल। आई एम फ्रॉम कैट कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग कोल्हापुर। टुडे मी एंड माय टीम इज गोइंग टू गिव प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन वायरलेस एंड ऑप्टिकल कम्युनिकेशन। सो दीज आर द कंटेंट्स ऑफ अवर प्रेजेंटेशन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द इंट्रोडक्शन। सो यू ऑल मस्ट बी वंडरिंग व्हाट इज मीन बाय वायरलेस एंड ऑप्टिकल कम्युनिकेशन। सो वायरलेस एंड ऑप्टिकल कम्युनिकेशन इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ ऑप्टिकल कम्युनिकेशन इन विच अनगाइडेड विजिबल इन्फ्रेड और अल्ट्रावायलेट लाइट विच कैरीज द सिग्नल एंड इन दिस सिस्टम इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव्स इन ओपन स्पेस ट्रांसमिट एंड रिसीव डाटा एंड वॉइस फ्रॉम वन पर्सन टू अनादर पर्सन एंड दिस इंफॉर्मेशन इज कैरीड टू अ वेल डिफाइंड चैनल एंड दिस वेल डिफाइंड चैनल हैज फिक्स फ्रिक्वेंसी बैंडविड्थ एंड कैपेसिटी एंड दिस कैपेसिटी इज मेजर्ड इन बिट रेट। एंड वॉट इज मीन बाय बिट रेट? सो बिट रेट इज अमाउंट ऑफ डाटा transmitted from one person to another person in fixed amount of time, and these different channels can be used to transmit information in parallel and independent way. So next point is typical frequencies. So there are some gadgets and they have some fixed amount of frequencies. So FM radio has 88 megahertz frequency and TV broadcast has 200 megahertz frequency. GSM means global system for mobile has 900 megahertz frequency, and GPS has 1.2 gigahertz frequency. PCS phone has 1.8 gigahertz frequency. Bluetooth has 2.4 gigahertz frequency. Wi-Fi has 2.4 gigahertz frequency. So the next point is comparison of wireless optical and radio channel. So the first point is RF circuit design. So wireless and optical communication has no RF circuit design, and radio system has RF circuit design. Bandwidth regulated. So wireless optical communication has no bandwidth regulated. So the radio communication system has bandwidth regulated, and wireless optical system has 100 Mbps data rates, and radio system has 1000 Mbps data rates. And wireless optical communication has high security system, but radio system has low security. And a wireless optical system does not passes through wall, but radio channels passes through walls. That's it.
Hi, myself Rutuja Porekar from KIT College of Engineering, Kolhapur. I'm going to tell you about how optical wireless communication works. Optical wireless system operates using wavelength ranging from 1330 nanometer to 1550 nanometer. These are the most common wavelength used in optical fiber. So moving to the working, as it consists of optical transmitter and optical receiver part. Optical transmitter is consist of WDM multiplexer, driver and LED or laser device, and optical receiver part is consist of WDM demultiplexer and detector circuit by using PIN diode. The photodiode detector produces an output electrical current, which is a measure of the optical power impinging of the device. The photodiode detector is often termed a square low device, since the device can also be modeled as squaring the amplitude of the incoming electromagnetic signal and integrating over time to find the intensity. So further moving to the advantages and disadvantages of the optical wireless system. Advantages: it has low cost baseband circuit design. The data transfer rate is up to 10 Gbps. Also, it covers the 1000 meter area. It is immune to interference. as it operates on ISM unlicensed bands, license related issues are not required to be tackled with. Optical wireless network is used as best optical complement technology along with RF based wireless network. It is highly secure as optical waves do not penetrate the walls. It can make use of cheaper optical fiber cables and components. Disadvantages: it cannot pass through walls, sensitive to blocking, transmit limited power. Also, it breaks in the optical link line of sight link, leads to huge loss of data. Moreover, atmospheric condition can lead to link failures. The typical examples are dense smoke, kites, birds, rain, etc.
My name is Vaishnavi Kasbekar. I am from HDVCHAT and my roll number is H30. I am telling about the channel topologies of wireless and optical communication. Second, diffuse link. Diffuse link is based on cellular layout with a single stations and a number of individual transmitter cell. A link is established when the transmitter is oriented towards a receiver. A diffuse transmit radiates optical power over a wide solid angle in order of easy pointing and shadowing to problems of point-to-point link. Diffuse link is provide mobility to the receiver. Diffuse link is also provide the high path long. Third, Cauchy diffuse link. Cauchy diffuse link is based on multi-spots diffusing. This system is established the fewer multi-paths and achieve the lower path loss. Second, Cauchy diffuse link is connected in ring to both point-to-point link indicators and diffuse connected in upgrade join throughout. Third, the transmitter unlike the roof with an arrangement gradually wandering the pillar source, while the unlike a lightly spots on the roof. The fourth, transmitter beam is made of utilizing the singular light cell. The slowly beam utilizing beam source is illuminated at the grid spot on the roof. Thank you.
Hi everyone, my name is Shruti Patankar and my roll number is 47. Today I am going to tell about applications of wireless and optical communication. First one is short range, chip-to-chip interface. In that, a number of different wireless technologies have been developed for very short distances. For example, Bluetooth. Short range signals can travel from centimeters to meters. Second one is medium range wireless optical. In that, as compared to short range signals, medium signals can travel from meters to 100 meters. Third one is long range free space optical communication. In that, long-range signals can travel from several kilometers to thousand several kilometers. So, these are the applications of wireless and optical communication. Next one is channel topologies. There are 3 points. First one is point-to-point link. Second one is diffuse link. Third one is quasi-diffuse link. We will see in detail in further slides. So here is point-to-point link. In telecommunications, a point-to-point connection refers to a communication connection between two communication endpoints or nodes. For example, telephone call. Point-to-point communication provided high bandwidth and a dedicated connection between two systems. Here are some points. First one is direct unobstructed path between a transmitter and a receiver. That is, point-to-point wireless optical links operate when there is a direct unobstructed path between a transmitter and a receiver. Link is established when the transmitter is oriented towards the receiver. And the second one is sensitive to blocking and shadowing.
Hello everyone, myself Shubham Udham. S30D is my roll call. Here I am presenting you the optical wireless LAN. Optical wireless LAN is the home used router which provides the data to your devices. So many peoples can be used in the home also, in office, but mostly peoples are used in the office only. This optical wireless LAN can connect to the multi devices, but we can put single also, or two connections, three connection or multi connection as your choice. It can be illuminated the rooms by serving the medium for data transferring uses. Long range optical communication. Long range optical communication can be used for high speed data transferring, but they also used in only in office or in cyber cafes. So they can provide high speed data to the long distances, but here we have the conclusion is they without any lesson they provide the bandwidth to the bandwidth communication to ourselves. So this is this special thing to ourselves. They provide the high data transferring to us. Thank you.